So to transition is to go from one place to the another.
Es de ir a un lugar a otro.
So it's entering into a new season.
Es el entrar a una nueva temporada.
How many of you guys are tired of living the way you're living?
¿Cuántos están cansados de vivir la forma que están viviendo?
How many of you guys want to see a change in your life?
¿Cuántos desean ver un cambio en su vida?
Well, God is going to transition you into another place.
Bueno, Dios les va a transicionar a otro lugar.
A better place.
A un lugar mejor.
How many of you guys believe that?
¿Cuántos lo creen?
Right? I don't hear you guys too excited,
no,
but I do.
Tan emocionados, pero yo sí lo
I want
creo.
To enter a new season.
Yo quiero entrar a una nueva temporada.
I know I want to enter to what God has in store for me.
Yo quiero entrar a lo que Dios tiene para mí.
And I understand maybe you guys are not too excited right now because maybe you don't know what is in store for me.
Y tal vez ahorita no están emocionados porque no saben qué es lo que Dios tiene para mí.
Y quizás no saben qué hay allí en esa nueva temporada.
And perhaps you don't know what there is in that new season.
Pero eso lo vamos a aprender ahora.
But we're going to learn that today.
I would like to read this Bible verse, Numbers 13, 25 through 30, and if I can have it projected on the screen. And I want you guys to read along with me. At the count of three, one, two, three. At the end of 40 days, they returned from exploring the land. They came back to Moses and Aaron and the whole Israelite community at Kadesh in the desert of Paran. There they reported to them and to the whole assembly and showed them the fruit of the land. So I want to give you guys a bit of a context to what is going on here.
Les quiero dar un poquito de contexto de qué es lo que estaba pasando aquí.
So how many of you guys have heard of the story of Moses and the Israelites?
¿Cuántos han escuchado de la historia de Moisés?
Okay.
Y el pueblo de Israel.
So God had chosen Moses to lead the people of Israel to their promised land.
Dios había escogido a Moisés para llevarse a las personas hacia la tierra prometida.
During this time, they still weren't there. They were on their journey there.
En ese tiempo, ellos aún no habían llegado. Todavía estaban en camino ahí.
And so God asked Moses to choose 12 spies.
Así que Dios escogió a Moisés para que escogiera a 12 espías.
Well, as a matter of fact, 12 leaders so that they can spy out the promised land.
A 12 líderes para que puedan hacer espías y ver la tierra prometida.
Well, what was going to be their promised land?
Lo que iba a ser la tierra prometida.
So right here we're gonna go ahead and read. We're gonna go back to this verse just so you guys have an idea what's going on here.
Y vamos a regresar al versículo.
And it says, at the end of 40 days, they returned from exploring the land. The spies returned. They came back to Moses and Aaron and the whole Israelite community at Kadesh in the desert of Paran. There they reported to them and to the whole assembly and showed them the fruit of the land. They gave Moses this account. We went into the land to which you sent us, and it does flow with milk and honey. Here is the fruit. If you can help me read that, Gabby.
Y dice, pero el pueblo que ahí habita es, all of it?
Yes, all of it, 25 to 30.
Okay. Y dice, después de explorar la tierra durante 40 días, los hombres regresaron a Moisés, Aarón y a toda la comunidad de Israel en Cades, en el desierto de Parán. Informaron a toda la comunidad lo que vieron y les mostraron los frutos que tomaron de la tierra. Este fue el informe que dieron a Moisés. Entramos a la tierra a la cual nos enviaste a explorar y en verdad es un país sobreabundante, una tierra donde fluyen la leche y la miel, y aquí está la clase de frutos que ahí se producen.
So was there good fruit there on this land? Yes or no?
Entonces, ¿había buena fruta en esa tierra? ¿Sí o no?
Yes, right?
Sí.
And there was big fruit. As a matter of fact, Pastor Lee showed a picture on last Sunday, I believe it was, where it showed a picture of some grapes where they were so huge that it took two people to actually carry that grapevine.
Y había fruta grande porque Pastor Lee mostró una foto de un ejemplo y estaban cargando uvas dos personas.
So that means it was a good land.
Porque era una buena tierra.
And these spies said that this is a good land.
Y los espías dijeron eso, dijeron, sí, es una buena tierra.
And many times I would like for you guys to project the picture of the promises of God. And many times in life, we're walking in life. And how many of you guys have believed the promises of God that he has for you, right? That our family will be saved, that we will be healthy, that we will be financially stable.
Y muchas veces creemos en las promesas de Dios que vamos a ser saludables, que vamos a tener estabilidad financieramente.
This represents the fruit.
Y esto eso significa el fruto.
So what has God promised for your life?
¿Y qué es lo que Dios ha prometido para tu vida?
Your family saved?
Tu familia que está
salva. How many
salva?
Of you guys believe that your family will be saved?
¿Cuántos creen que su familia
Amen.
Pueden ser salvos?
I'm still waiting for family members to be saved, and I believe it.
Yo aún estoy esperando, pero yo lo creo.
How many of you guys want to receive joy?
¿Cuántos quieren recibir gozo?
Be financially blessed. How many of you guys want to be financially blessed?
¿Cuántos quieren estar bendecidos financieramente y no tener deudas?
Good health.
Una buena salud.
If you don't have a citizenship, your citizenship.
Si no tienes una ciudadanía, tu ciudadanía.
Free from anxiety.
Estar libre de ansiedad.
With peace.
Con paz.
Serving God.
Sirviendo a Dios.
Winning souls.
Ganando almas.
That fruit that we read here.
El fruto que leemos aquí.
That what's in the promised land are these things that God has in store for us.
Lo que está en la tierra prometida son estas cosas, lo que Dios tiene para
nosotros.
Healthy
friendships.
Buenas amistades.
How many of you guys want new friends, healthy friendships?
¿Cuántos quisieran tener buenas amistades, amistades saludables?
Friends that will be there for you, who will pray for you, who will not tell you to go and smoke or have sex with someone.
Amistades que van a estar ahí, que van a orar por ti, que no te van a decir que vayas a fumar o que tengas sexo con alguien.
How many of you guys want to be free from depression?
¿Cuántos quieren ser libres de la depresión?
So if we continue reading in Numbers 13, 28 through 29, we're going to see something different now. So this was a good report that they were bringing. They said it was a good, healthy land, right?
Dicen que era una tierra muy buena donde había fruto.
Now we're going to read something a little bit different. It says, but the people who live there are powerful and the cities are fortified and very large. We even saw descendants of Anak there. And I want to give you guys a little bit of a background. So the descendants of Anak were considered a very strong race back in that day. They were considered strong people.
Los descendientes de Anak antes eran considerados personas muy fuertes.
And they were considered to be like very, very tall.
Y considerados que eran muy altos.
I was doing my research, so I was like, okay, I wonder why they said the descendants of Anak.
Yo me preguntaba por qué hablaban así de los descendientes de Anak.
So in their eyes, they were seeing that this was an obstacle.
Pero en sus ojos ellos miraban que esto era un obstáculo.
And if we continue reading,
y si seguimos leyendo,
in verse 29 it says that the Amalekites? I don't want to pronounce it wrong.
Amalekites.
Amalekites live in the Negev, and the Hittites, Jebusites, and the Amorites live in the hill country, and the Canaanites live near the sea and along the Jordan. And that was the river, right? So they're here explaining all the reasons why maybe they couldn't conquer that promised land.
Entonces ellos estaban explicando todas las razones por qué no podían conquistar la tierra prometida.
If you guys can leave the Bible verse there. And right there at the beginning of that Bible verse, it says, but. That means there was obstacles.
Y en el comienzo decía, sin embargo. Significa que había obstáculos.
What are your obstacles that you're facing?
¿Cuáles son los obstáculos que tú estás enfrentando ahorita?
Because right there, that was impeding them to see what God had in store for them. It was impeding them to see the good things, what was the milk and honey that was flowing in that land.
Porque eso les estaba haciendo a ellos evitar de ver la leche y la miel que estaba en la tierra prometida.
So many times in life, we're going to face obstacles that will rob our vision.
Así que muchas veces en la vida vamos a enfrentar obstáculos que nos van a robar de la visión.
And if you guys can help me project that next slide. Many times we're going to face either sickness.
Muchas veces vamos a enfrentar lo que es enfermedad.
How many of you guys have struggled with a sickness?
¿Cuántos han batallado con alguna enfermedad? Levanten su mano.
That can be an obstacle. That can rob your vision.
Eso puede ser un obstáculo. Eso puede robar tu visión.
Resentment.
El resentimiento.
Failures can rob your vision.
Fracasos pueden robar tu visión.
I don't know about you guys, but I remember when I first started my walk with Christ, I remember believing God in everything.
Yo no sé ustedes, pero yo me recuerdo como comencé mi viaje con Cristo, yo creía en Dios para todo.
I believed him in my family being saved and being free from depression, from anxiety. I believed him in being free from resentment.
Yo le creía que mi familia iba a ser rescatada, que no iba a haber resentimiento, que yo iba a ser libre.
But as I continued my walk with Christ and I started walking towards my purpose,
pero mientras caminaba hacia mi propósito,
I started facing obstacles.
Comencé a enfrentar obstáculos.
And I'm sure you guys can relate. I'm sure I'm not the only one who has gone through this, but how many of you guys have ever faced resentments?
Imagino que no soy la única. ¿Cuántos han enfrentado resentimiento?
Right? So I had these guys help me here. Thank you guys for helping me with this illustration, but they represent the obstacles.
Ellos representan los obstáculos.
That maybe the spies had allowed them to rob their vision.
Que tal vez los espías dejaron que le robara la visión.
And that we've allowed for it to rob our vision as well.
Y que nosotros hemos permitido que nos robe nuestra visión.
Maybe financial problems.
Tal vez problemas financieros.
Maybe before you believed God that you would be free of debt.
Tal vez antes creías que Dios te podía hacer libre de las deudas.
That you would be a millionaire.
Que iba a ser millonario.
How many of you guys have ever believed that and have seen and envisioned yourself being a millionaire?
¿Cuántos han visionado que han sido millonarios? Yo lo he creído.
But many times financial problems come and that can rob our vision.
Y a veces los problemas financieros vienen y nos roban la visión.
Disappointments.
Las decepciones.
Maybe problems at home. Maybe seeing your parents fight at home.
Problemas en la casa, ves a tus padres discutir.
Maybe seeing all that division at home.
Ver toda la división en tu casa.
The alcohol at home.
El alcohol en la casa.
The screaming, the yelling at home.
El gritar en la casa.
Maybe the abuse at home.
Tal vez el abuso que hay en el hogar.
That can rob your vision.
Eso te puede robar la visión.
Maybe comfort.
Tal vez el estar cómodos.
And I feel like this is a little bit more for the people here that are serving. I felt that strongly.
Y eso lo sentí fuertemente para todos aquellos que están sirviendo.
And that are active in church. Sometimes comfort has robbed our vision.
A veces la comodidad nos ha robado la visión.
And God wants to set us free from that.
Y Dios nos quiere hacer libre de eso.
What about marital problems?
Tal vez problemas matrimoniales.
That has robbed our vision sometimes.
Eso nos ha robado la visión a veces.
How many of you guys are married here? Raise up your hand.
¿Cuántos aquí están casados? Levante su mano.
What about failures?
¿Qué tal fracasos?
Maybe you tried doing something and you failed at it.
Tal vez trataste de hacer algo pero fallaste.
What about anxiety?
¿Qué tal ansiedad?
Those panic attacks.
Los ataques de pánico.
That has robbed your vision.
¿Qué te ha robado la visión?
From seeing God's vision for your life and living in peace.
¿Y no te ha dejado ver la visión de Dios para tu vida y vivir en paz?
What about betrayal?
¿Qué tal los?
How many of you have ever been betrayed by a friend?
¿Cuántos han sido engañados antes por un amigo, una amistad?
A boyfriend, a girlfriend.
Un novio, una novia.
That hurts.
Eso duele.
That robs our vision.
Eso nos roba nuestra visión.
What about rejection? Addiction to pornography.
¿Qué tal el rechazo, la adicción a pornografía?
Those are some things that can rob our vision. Addictions, addiction to marijuana, alcohol, drugs.
La adicción a las drogas, al alcohol.
Family members, like I said, not being saved yet.
Familiares que aún no han sido rescatados.
And maybe you've been praying and praying and pacting, coming to the altar and pacting for a family member. How many of you guys have ever pacted for a family member to be saved?
Y tal vez han estado orando. ¿Cuántos han pactado antes para que se le rescate un familiar?
Sometimes not seeing the response, that can rob our vision.
A veces no viendo la respuesta te puede robar la visión.
Maybe sickness.
Tal vez una enfermedad.
God has already seen you healed.
Dios ya te ve sano.
But yet you've allowed that diagnostics to rob your vision.
Pero a veces dejamos que el diagnóstico que te robe la visión.
Maybe jealousy has robbed your vision.
Tal vez los celos te han robado la visión.
You've been comparing yourself to someone else.
Te has comparado con alguien más.
You've envied what someone else has, what they do.
Te has tenido envidia con lo que otras personas tienen.
That has robbed your vision.
Y eso te ha robado la visión.
That has contaminated your vision, your heart.
Ha contaminado tu visión, tu corazón.
Depression, sadness.
La depresión, la tristeza.
And sometimes you say, but why do I keep feeling this way?
Y tal vez dices, ¿por qué me sigo sintiendo de esta forma?
Nothing can take away this sadness.
Nada me quita esta tristeza.
What about addictions? Like I mentioned, addiction to pornography, to whatever it is, you name it. Only you know. God knows.
Las diferentes tipos de adicciones, tú puedes nombrarlas. Dios ya sabe cuáles son.
Thank you guys. These are some obstacles that can rob us from seeing what God has in store for us.
Esos son algunos obstáculos que nos pueden robar de lo que Dios tiene para nosotros.
Like I said, ask yourself this question. What are those obstacles right now?
Pregúntense, ¿cuáles son esos obstáculos ahorita?
In your life.
En tu vida.
Maybe you've never shared it with anyone what you're struggling with right now.
Tal vez nunca has compartido con lo que estás batallando con nadie.
But God knows what you're going through.
Pero Dios sabe lo que estás pasando.
Like I said, before it was so easy for us to believe God in everything.
Como dije antes, era bien fácil que pudiéramos creerle a Dios para todo.
But then so many things contaminated your vision.
Pero después las cosas comenzaron a contaminar tu visión.
And we're no longer living the life that God intended us to live.
Y ya no estamos viviendo la vida que Dios quería que vivamos.
How many of you guys have ever felt like a fish without water, like you just feel so lost.
¿Cuántos se han sentido como un pez sin agua?
Raise up your hand.
Que se sienten perdidos. Levanta
There's
tu mano.
Power when you raise up your hand.
Hay
and
poder
you're
cuando levantas tu mano y dices la verdad.
I want to read a Bible verse that says, it's Proverbs 29:18. And I'm actually going to read two versions of it.
Proverbios 29:18.
It says, where there is no vision, the people perish. And then the Message version says, if people can't see what God is doing, they stumble all over themselves.
Si las personas no pueden ver lo que Dios está haciendo, cuando no hay dirección del Señor, el pueblo se extravía.
Yes, so when you don't see what God sees for your life,
así que cuando no ves lo que Dios ve para tu vida,
when you have no vision,
cuando no tienes visión,
you're always going to be stumbling in life.
Siempre vas a estar batallando en la vida.
You're going to be falling and tripping.
Te vas a estar tropezando cada rato.
It doesn't matter how hard you want to run or walk.
No importa qué tan fuerte quieras correr o caminar.
You're going to keep stumbling.
Vas a seguir tropezándote.
Because you have no vision.
Porque no tienes visión.
And something that God put in my heart, and I feel like I know He was speaking to me.
Y yo sé que Dios me estaba hablando cuando me puso algo en mi corazón.
And He said to me, if your vision is limited,
y me dijo, si tu visión es limitada,
your life will be limited.
Tu vida será limitada.
And this is for some of you guys tonight.
Y eso es para alguno de ustedes esta noche.
Has your life been limited lately?
¿Tu vida ha estado limitada últimamente?
It's because your vision has been limited.
Es porque tu visión ha estado limitada.
And God wants to give you a fresh vision tonight.
Y Dios te quiere dar una visión fresca esta noche.
How many of you guys want a fresh vision tonight?
¿Cuántos quieren una visión fresca en esta noche? Porque yo lo quiero.
And like how it said in this Bible verse.
Y como dije en este versículo.
If people can't see what God is doing,
si las personas no pueden ver lo que Dios está haciendo,
they stumble all over themselves.
Se van a tropezar sobre sí mismos.
I've stumbled all over myself.
Yo me he tropezado.
I've stumbled so bad in life before.
Me he tropezado tan frecuente en la vida antes.
And I actually want to share a little bit of my testimony.
Y yo quiero compartir un poquito de mi testimonio.
I'm sure you guys, some of you guys already know, but at the age of 8.
Tal vez saben, pero a la edad de 8 años,
I was introduced to pornography.
Fui introducida a la pornografía.
And to masturbation by a cousin.
Y una masturbación a través de una prima.
And I remember that she would make me watch these things and do these things to myself.
Y yo me recuerdo que ella me forzaba a ver estas cosas y hacerme estas cosas a mí misma.
And I felt so unworthy.
Y me sentía tan indigna.
I had so much anger and resentment towards her.
Tenía tanto enojo y resentimiento hacia ella.
And I blamed her for robbing my innocence.
Y le culpaba por robarme mi inocencia.
Then later on, when I was 14, around there, my parents got divorced.
Y después cuando tenía como 15, mis padres se divorciaron.
That hurt so much.
Y eso me dolió tanto.
I felt like my world was falling apart.
Sentía que se me estaba acabando el mundo.
I felt so lost. I had even more anger.
Me sentía tan perdida, aún tenía más enojo.
Not only did I have anger and resentment towards my cousin, but now towards my mom because my mom wasn't faithful to my dad and they split up.
No solamente tenía enojo y resentimiento por mi prima, pero ahora tenía enojo y resentimiento contra mi mamá porque ella le engañó a mi papá y por eso se separaron.
And that led for me to feeling so angry, so having so much resentment. It led to depression, anxiety.
Y eso me llevó a estar tan enojada que me llevó a depresión y ansiedad.
And I remember that I wished death upon my mom.
Y me recuerdo que le deseaba que mi mamá se fuera a morir.
And I even said it.
Y yo me recuerdo que lo dije una vez.
And I remember feeling so lonely, I started seeking for love and affirmation from guys.
Y me recuerdo estando tan sola que comenzaba a buscar afirmación y amor de parte de los muchachos.
I didn't have no vision for my life.
No tenía visión para mi vida.
I had allowed these obstacles to rob my vision for what God had in store for me.
Había dejado que esos obstáculos me roben la visión de lo que Dios tenía para mí.
And I remember that when I was from guy to guy, I ended up entering this abusive relationship where I became pregnant and I committed abortion.
Me recuerdo que me fui de muchacho a muchacho y entré en una relación donde me embaracé y tuve que tener un aborto.
I chose to have an abortion.
Yo decidí hacer un aborto.
And I remember I blamed myself so much.
Y me recuerdo que yo me culpé tanto.
I felt so unworthy.
Me sentí tan indigna.
Not only did I hate all these people that caused pain in my life and towards this guy that was abusive towards me, but I hated myself.
No solamente odiaba a todas esas personas que me hicieron tanto daño, pero yo me odiaba a mí misma.
I didn't know what God had in store for me.
Yo no sabía qué es lo que Dios tenía para mí.
No one told me that God loves me, that He would set me free, that He would heal me.
Nadie me dijo que Dios me ama, que Él me haría libre, que Él me podría sanar.
No one told me that there was a promised land in store for me.
Nadie me dijo que había una tierra prometida para mí.
And I remember that I felt so depressed to the point where I started cutting myself.
Y yo me recuerdo que caí en tanta depresión que me comencé a cortar.
And I remember it got to a point where I wanted to commit suicide. You guys can help me with the pictures.
Que llegó un punto donde comencé a, quise cometer suicidio.
And you may see me right now here preaching, but to be honest, I was really, really bad. I went through so much.
Y tal vez ahorita me pueden ver predicando, pero yo pasé por tantas cosas.
Right there is a picture of my thighs. That's actually, I took that today, and I have scars in both of my thighs of how much I would cut myself.
Y eso lo tomé una foto de mis piernas porque tengo cicatrices porque yo me cortaba.
I didn't know my worth.
No sabía mi valor.
I didn't know I was valuable. I was loved.
No sabía que yo tenía valor y que era amada.
Right there, moments before that, I actually got high.
Antes de eso, yo ya me había intoxicado.
This was on a 4th of July, and I remember that I felt so much pain that I was addicted to marijuana.
Y eso era un 4 de julio. Yo estaba en tanto dolor que me comencé a ser adicta a la marihuana.
I didn't have any self-worth. All I wanted was affirmation from other people, I was super provocative because all I wanted was attention. I didn't know my worth.
Solamente quería atención porque no sabía mi valor.
And I remember there that night I actually I ran away from home.
Esa noche yo me recuerdo que yo me huí de la casa.
And I remember that I went to the strip with my friends and I started drinking.
Y me fui a la strip con mis amigos y yo comencé a tomar.
And I remember that I ended up in the streets and I remember waking up and no one was there.
Y yo me recuerdo que estaba en las calles y un día me levanté y no había nadie ahí.
My friends had left me.
Mis amigos me habían dejado.
I didn't know the direction of my life. I felt lost.
No sabía la dirección de mi vida, me sentía perdida.
I felt lonely. I felt rejected.
Me sentía sola, rechazada.
All the obstacles that we read here, I feel like I had them all.
Todos los obstáculos que leímos, yo sentía que los tenía todos.
I had allowed all those things to rob my vision.
Había dejado que todas esas cosas me roben mi visión.
But I want to go ahead and share some other pictures, if we can. And I it's crazy because that's how I saw myself.
Y así es como yo me miraba.
In dealing with all of those things and all of those obstacles.
Lidiando con todas esas cosas y todos esos obstáculos.
But God had already seen me out of there. He had seen me free.
Pero Dios ya me había visto fuera de eso, ya me había hecho libre.
God had already seen this.
Dios ya había visto
Even
esto.
Though I was there in my misery, God had already seen me with my beautiful family.
Aunque yo ya estaba en mi miseria, en ese momento Dios me había visto con mi bonita familia.
If you can leave it there, please, with my family. I remember feeling so unworthy and I felt like I was never going to have children because I didn't deserve to be a mother.
Me recuerdo que me sentía tan indigna y decía, yo nunca voy a tener hijos porque me sentía mal siendo una mamá.
I never saw that I would have children.
Nunca me había visto poder tener hijos otra vez.
I never saw that I would be married.
Nunca miraba que yo podía estar casada.
Because my parents went through a divorce and that's all I could see.
Porque mis padres pasaron por un divorcio y es lo único que yo podía ver.
I couldn't see past that. No, I thought that's what I had to go through too.
No podía ver más allá que eso. Yo pensaba que eso es lo que yo iba a pasar también.
I was so afraid to go into a marriage because I thought they were going to cheat on me too.
Tenía tanto miedo entrar a un matrimonio porque yo pensé que me iban a engañar a mí también.
But God has seen my marriage already.
Pero Dios ya miraba mi matrimonio.
God had seen my children.
Dios ya había mirado mis hijos.
And I'm so grateful for that.
Y estoy muy agradecido por
that
eso.
Even though I don't deserve it, He saw me there.
Porque aunque yo no lo merecía, Él ya me miraba ahí.
It doesn't matter what you have done. It doesn't matter what you're going through. God sees you on the other side already.
No importa qué has hecho, qué es lo que has pasado, Dios ya te mira al otro lado.
Stop seeing your obstacles. Stop seeing your circumstances.
Para de mirar tus obstáculos, tus circunstancias.
If we can go on to the next picture. I remember, how many of you guys here are wanting to buy a house?
¿Cuántos aquí quieren comprar una casa?
Would like to own a house?
¿O que quieren ser dueños de una
Raise
casa?
Up your hand.
Levanten su mano.
Me and my husband did too.
Mi esposo y yo también queríamos eso.
But I actually want to share something with you guys. I don't think I've ever shared it.
Y yo no creo que hemos compartido esto antes.
But I remember when my parents were together, from when I was born to when I was 14.
Yo me recuerdo que cuando mis padres estaban juntos desde que éramos pequeños hasta que cumplí 14 años.
My family and I lived in a garage.
Vivíamos en un garaje.
And I remember sometimes looking at my friends going over to my friend's house.
Y yo me recuerdo cuando me iba a visitar a mis amigas en su casa.
And I would say, I want my own home. I want my own room.
Y yo decía, yo quiero mi propia casa. Yo quiero mi propio cuarto.
I'm tired of living in a garage.
Estoy cansada de vivir en un garaje.
I'm tired of sharing my room. I want my privacy.
Estoy cansada de compartir un cuarto. Yo quiero mi propia privacidad.
I'm tired of living in this poverty.
Estoy cansada de vivir en esta escasez.
But you know what? God already saw me. He had already seen me with my home.
Pero Dios ya me había visto con mi propia casa.
I don't know what you're going through. I don't know what your parents' situation, but God already sees you guys with your own home.
Yo no sé qué es lo que estás pasando, qué es lo que la situación de tus padres, pero Dios ya te mira con tu propia casa.
And to give God all the glory, this was God made this possible. We were able to purchase our home last year.
Y pudimos comprar nuestra casa el año pasado.
And we're so grateful for that.
Y estamos tan agradecidos por eso.
I didn't see that when I was going through that.
Yo no miré eso cuando yo estaba pasando por eso.
But God did.
Pero Dios sí lo miraba.
If we can go to the next picture. This is my mom praying for me today.
Esta es mi mamá orando por mí hoy.
Like I said, I had so much resentment towards my mom.
Yo tenía tanto resentimiento con mi mamá.
I never thought that I could have a relationship with my mom.
Nunca pensé que yo podía tener una relación con mi mamá.
After what she did to me.
Después de lo que ella me hizo.
I couldn't say I love you to my mom.
No le podía decir te amo a mi mamá.
Every time I heard that word, it just gave me like, oh, it just got me so cringe and it made me want to puke. It was that bad.
Cada vez que yo le decía esa palabra me incomodaba tanto que sentía que quería vomitar.
I couldn't tell my mom I love you.
No le podía decir te amo.
Because of all the pain and the resentment I had towards her.
Por todo el dolor y el resentimiento que le tenía.
I never thought that I would have a good relationship with my mom.
Nunca pensé que podía tener una buena relación con mi mamá.
I remember growing up, my mom went through so much. Now I know.
Me recuerdo que cuando mi mamá creció, ella también pasó por muchas cosas.
And I don't blame her for what she made us go through. I mean, it was her pain.
Y no la culpo por lo que nos hizo pasar, porque ella también era su dolor de ella.
I don't judge her.
Yo no la juzgo.
But I remember growing up, and all she would do was curse us.
Y yo me recuerdo cuando estábamos creciendo, y solamente nos decía malas palabras.
She would scream at us, but maybe out of her frustration.
Y tal vez era de su frustración.
And I remember it hurting me so much.
Y me recuerdo que me lastimaba tanto.
But it touched me today because maybe during that time she cursed us. And I couldn't see her ever. Like I couldn't ever see having a good relationship with my mom.
Y tal vez en esa temporada ella nos maldecía y yo no podía ver tener una buena relación con mi mamá.
But here she's praying for me.
Pero aquí ella está orando por mí.
She was praying for me because she knew I would preach today.
Orando porque ella sabía que iba a predicar el día de hoy.
And you know how good that felt.
¿Y sabes qué bueno se sintió eso?
That at some point I never saw that I would tell my mom I love you, but now I can say it freely.
Que a un punto yo nunca pensaba que le podía decir te amo y ahora lo digo tan libremente.
I couldn't see her the way God sees saw her.
No la podía ver como Dios la miraba.
But now I can say I love my mom and I see her the way God does.
Y ahora le puedo decir que te amo y la puedo ver como Dios la ve.
And I don't know why, but I feel strongly from God that God will give you the vision to see those people how He sees them, how they are in the future.
Y yo siento que Dios te va a dar la visión para que tú puedas ver a las personas como Él las ve, como ellos van a ser en el futuro.
And sometimes my siblings can judge me because they're like, oh, you're too nice to my mom, or oh, why do you do this for her? Why do you, oh, you're too nice.
Y a veces mis hermanos me juzgan y dicen, ay, eres muy buena con mi mamá, ¿por qué haces esto con ella, por ella?
Oh, you should just tell her this or that.
Ay, debes decirle tal cosa.
But you know why? Because I have asked God to give me His eyes so that I can see her the way He sees her.
Pero ¿sabes por qué? Porque yo le pido a Dios que me dé la manera de verla como tú Él la mira.
Because even though yes, she's in church, she has her struggles. She's not perfect. She still has her own battles.
Porque aunque ella venga a la iglesia, ella tiene sus batallas, no es perfecta.
And there's some things that we don't agree with.
Y hay cosas en las cuales estamos en desacuerdo.
But I have always told God, grant me your vision so I can see her as a finished product the way that you see her.
Y siempre le he dicho, dame tu visión para verla como el producto terminado como tú la ves.
Because if I don't see her the way you see her, I won't be able to love her and treat her the way you would want me to.
Porque si yo no la veo como tú la ves, yo no la podría amar y tratar como tú quisieras que lo haga.
It's crucial for us to transvision.
Es crucial que podamos transvisionar.
We must transvision in order to transition.
Necesitamos transicionar para poder transicionar.
And what does the word transvision mean?
¿Y qué significa transicionar?
Well, I want to break it down, and the word trans means to reach the other side. That's simply what it means.
La palabra trans significa ir al otro lado.
I know we hear the word trans and it has other meanings and the world has used it wrongly.
Y sabemos que en el mundo la palabra trans tiene otras definiciones y el mundo lo ha usado incorrectamente.
But it simply means to reach the other side, to cross over.
Pero significa llegar al otro lado, cruzar al otro lado.
3 weeks ago, Pastor Luis preached about, he was talking about how we must cross the Jordan River to get to our promised land. How many of you guys remember?
Hace 3 semanas, Pastor Luis hablaba de que teníamos que cruzar el río Jordán para llegar a nuestra tierra prometida.
Trans, reach the other side.
Trans es llegar al otro lado.
Sight.
Visión.
Sorry, vision.
La visión.
The next part. So it's trans means to go to the other side, to reach the other side.
Trans significa llegar al otro lado.
Sight means, sorry, vision means the ability to think about or plan the future with imagination.
Visión significa la habilidad de poder pensar y planificar el futuro con imaginación.
It means to see with the eyes of faith.
Significa ver con ojos de fe.
It's the ability to see things, people, places, the way God sees them in the future.
Es la capacidad de ver cosas, personas en la forma en que Dios los ve en el futuro.
And I want to read a Bible verse that says 2 Corinthians 5:7. It says, "For we live by faith, not by sight."
En efecto, vivimos por fe y no por vista.
God knew that we needed to live by faith and not by sight.
Dios sabía que teníamos que vivir por fe y no por vista.
He knew that we needed vision.
Sabía que necesitábamos visión.
Not our sight.
No nuestra vista.
Sight is only what we can physically see.
La vista es solamente lo que nosotros físicamente podemos ver.
So what's the difference from sight and vision?
¿Y qué es la diferencia entre vista y visión?
Sight is what I see right now. What you see me right now, I see you, that is it.
Vista es de que yo les veo a ustedes, ustedes me ven a mí. Eso es todo.
Vision, like we read right now.
Y visión, lo que acabamos de leer,
is the ability to see people, things and places the way God sees them, but in the future.
Es la capacidad de ver cosas, personas en la forma en que Dios los ve en el futuro.
It's imagining and planning in the future.
Es el imaginar y planear en el futuro.
Vision is what we need.
Visión es lo que necesitamos.
What can vision do?
¿Y qué puede hacer la visión?
And if you guys can help me with the next set of pictures. We will look over, no, the next ones. Next ones, right there. So these are examples of people who transvisioned.
Y esos son ejemplos de personas que transvisionaron.
So Walt Disney.
Walt Disney.
Like how we heard Pastor Luis say that Walt Disney had to first imagine it. He had to first have that idea and envision Walt Disney Park. How many of you guys have ever been to Walt Disney?
Walt Disney tuvo que visionar Walt Disney Park. ¿Cuántos han ido a Disney antes? ¿Cuántos han ido a Disney antes?
If you haven't, you will.
Si no lo han hecho, van a ir.
So Walt Disney had to first envision this theme park.
Entonces él primeramente tuvo que imaginarse, envisionarse este parque.
In order for it to come into reality.
Para que se pueda hacer realidad.
As a matter of fact, he was saying that Walt Disney wasn't able to see it actually physically with his own eyes.
Y él compartía que Walt Disney no podía verlo con sus propios ojos.
Before he died.
Antes de fallecer.
But it touched me how his wife said in the inauguration, she said that he had already seen it.
Y en la inauguración me impresionó como su esposa había dicho de que él ya lo había visto.
As a matter of fact, the ones who were seeing it for the first time was the people there, because he had already seen it. He had envisioned it in order for it to have been come to life.
Que los primeros que eran la primera vez que lo habían visto eran ellos, porque él ya lo había envisionado para poder crearlo.
Another example of someone who transvisioned was Noah.
Otro ejemplo fue Noé.
Imagine making an ark when it had never rained.
Imagínate crear un arca cuando nunca había llovido.
Imagine getting judged. People might have thought he was crazy.
Imagínate que las personas pensaban que estaba loco.
How in the world would you build an ark this big old boat when it had never rained?
¿Cómo vas a construir este gran arca cuando nunca ha llovido?
Noah had to transvision.
Él tenía que transvisionar.
He had to have this vision.
Tenía que tener esta visión.
God gave him a vision to construct it because he showed him what would happen. He told him what would happen.
Dios le dio una visión para que él pueda construir lo que iba a pasar.
He transitioned.
Él transicionó.
Sorry, he transvisioned.
Él transvisionó.
Another person, another example would be Moses' mother.
Otra es la mamá de Moisés.
Imagine putting your baby, your son, on a basket on a river.
Imagínate poner a tu hijo en un río.
At that time, all the babies were being killed where they lived.
En ese tiempo estaban matando a todos los bebés cuando estaban en ese tiempo.
Well, the boy babies, the male babies. And I remember that reading this, and it impacted me so much because I'm like, man, like she had to have this vision that if she placed him on the river, that he would be saved and he would fulfill his purpose.
Y me sorprendió porque yo dije, man, ella tenía que tener una visión porque para poder ponerlo en el río, que él iba a cumplir su propósito.
Because if not, I'm sure she wouldn't have put him there.
Porque yo imagino que si no, no lo hubiera puesto.
But she envisioned it. God showed her this vision, the plan.
Pero Dios le mostró su propósito, su plan.
And now obviously we know of Moses, we're reading his story right now, that he was the one who led the people of Israel to the promised land. He wasn't crossover into the promised land, but he led them. He was their leader.
Y ahora sabemos de Moisés de que él llevó a los israelitas al pueblo, a la tierra prometida. Él no pudo entrar, pero llevó a las personas ahí.
Another example of someone who transvisioned, Jesus.
Un ejemplo de alguien que transvisionó fue Jesús.
On the cross, imagine being on the cross.
Imagínate estando en la cruz.
Seeing how people rejected him, people didn't believe in his father.
Ver cómo las personas lo rechazaban, no creían en su padre.
He knew that the people didn't deserve it, but yet.
Él sabía que las personas no se lo merecían, pero aún así.
He chose to die for them because God showed him a vision.
Decidió morir por ellos porque Dios demostró una visión.
He knew his purpose.
Él sabía su propósito.
That even though you and I did not deserve it, it was necessary for him to be on that cross so that we may be free.
Que aunque tú y yo no nos merecíamos, era necesario que estuviera en la cruz para que nosotros podríamos ser salvos y libres.
Yes, and another person who transvisioned was apostle.
Y otra persona que transvisionó fue apóstol y profeta.
It's crazy to think that in the middle of recession, in the middle of where there was, I mean, people were not buying things. People were losing their homes and jobs and whatnot.
Y el hecho que en medio de una recesión las personas estaban perdiendo sus trabajos, sus casas.
God placed a vision in him that we would build our own temple.
Que Dios le puso una visión que íbamos a construir nuestro propio templo.
God had given this vision.
Dios le dio esa visión.
He had to transvision. He had to see it first and look at us now.
Él tuvo que transvisionar y él lo tuvo que ver primero y míranos ahora.
You and I are here because someone chose to transvision.
Tú y yo estamos aquí porque alguien decidió transvisionar.
Someone chose to believe God's vision for his life and for the church.
Alguien decidió creer en la visión y el propósito que él tenía para la iglesia, para Dios.
And that got me thinking, wow, like the fact that there is weight in receiving a fresh vision and believing God.
Y eso me hizo pensar en el peso que hay en creer en esa visión, en creerle a Dios.
Imagine if Dad would not have transvisioned and believed God.
Imagínate si apóstol no hubiera transvisionado y no hubiera creído a Dios.
You and I would not be here.
No estuviéramos aquí.
Thousands of people would not have gone to the retreat, to a service over here, and be healed and freed.
Miles de personas no hubieran ido a un retiro, no hubieran asistido a un servicio donde hubieran recibido sanidad o liberación.
Thousands of people would not have known Jesus.
Miles de personas no hubieran conocido a Jesús.
How many of you guys have ever felt like you've lost your vision? If you guys can, if I can have you guys close your eyes.
Cierren sus ojos.
How many of you guys have ever felt like you've lost your vision?
¿Cuántos han sentido que han perdido su visión? Levante su mano.
Lift it up high without shame. Forget about the person who's next to you.
Olvídense de la persona a la par suya.
Like I said before.
Como les dije antes.
If you don't have vision, your life will be limited.
Si no tienes visión, tu vida será limitada.
It's time to ask God for a fresh vision.
Es tiempo que le preguntes a Dios por una visión fresca.
Father, my God, I ask you that you place a fresh vision unto these youth and myself, Father.
Padre, te pido que pongas una visión fresca en estos jóvenes y en mí.
Give us the ability to see things and people and places the way that you see them.
Danos la habilidad de poder ver cosas, personas y lugares como tú los ves.
Give us a fresh vision.
Danos una visión fresca.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Amen. Amen. You can open your eyes.
Puedes abrir tus ojos.
And you may say to yourself, okay, now I know, what are some obstacles? What are some things? I know that I have lost my vision.
Y tal vez dices, okay, ya sé que hay obstáculos y tal vez ya perdí mi visión.
Now, how can I gain my vision back?
¿Cómo puedo recuperar la visión nuevamente?
We must come to God.
Debemos acercarnos a Dios.
Because He is the source of our vision.
Porque Él es la fuente de nuestra visión.
The word of God says in Colossians 1:16-17.
La palabra de Dios dice en Colosenses.
For in him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities. All things have been created through him and for him. He is before all things and in him all things hold together. If you can help me read that in Spanish, please. And if not, it's okay, but right here we read that all things were created by him.
Leemos que todas estas cosas fueron creadas por él.
He has created all things. So that thing that you're going through, he has already seen it because he created it.
Él ha creado tantas cosas que esa cosa que estás pasando ahorita, él ya lo sabe porque él la creó.
He is the source of our vision.
Él es la fuente de nuestra visión.
He created everything.
Él creó todo.
And something I do want to say is that he's omnipresent. How many of you guys have heard the word omnipresent?
¿Cuántos han escuchado la palabra omnipresente?
And if you don't know, if you've never heard of it, the word omnipresent means that you're in a place, you're everywhere at the same time.
Significa que tú estás en todas partes a la misma vez.
And I was thinking about this.
Y yo estaba meditando en esto.
And I was like, God, like you know what we're going through right now. You know what I'm going through right now.
Y yo le decía, Dios, tú sabes lo que estamos pasando. Tú sabes lo que yo estoy pasando ahorita.
You see what we're going through.
Tú ves lo que estamos pasando.
You understand what we're going through.
Entiendes lo que estamos pasando.
You're there with us right now with what we're going through.
Estás ahí con nosotros en lo que estamos pasando.
Because you're everywhere at the same time.
Porque estás en todas partes a la misma vez.
But then you're also there where we have already reached the other side.
Pero también estás donde ya hemos alcanzado el otro lado.
You're already there, us as a finished product.
Y estás donde ya estamos como un producto final acabado.
O sea, tú estás aquí con nosotros en lo que estamos pasando.
Meaning you're here where we are and what we're going through.
Pero también estás allá del otro lado donde ya el producto final, ya somos el producto final.
You're also on the other side where we're already the final product.
And that's crazy. God is everywhere. He is the source of our vision. He already saw you reaching the other side. He already saw you on the other side of that addiction. He saw you on the other side of that depression. He saw you free. He saw you delivered already.
Y Dios ya te vio libre de esa adicción. Te hizo libre de esa depresión. Ya te vio libre.
So why are we still there?
Entonces, ¿por qué seguimos ahí?
When God had seen you already.
Cuando Dios ya te había visto.
In your promised land.
En tu tierra prometida.
We need to be able to see ourselves the way God sees us.
Tenemos que poder vernos como Dios nos ve.
And it's crazy because I was thinking, wow, like right now, the fact that I'm here right now, God had already seen it.
Y yo pensaba, wow, like yo, el hecho que estoy aquí, Dios ya había visto esto.
Even though maybe I didn't see it at some point.
Aunque tal vez yo no lo miraba en un punto.
But God had already seen me here.
Pero Dios ya me había visto aquí.
Even though maybe some people didn't see me here, but God saw me here.
Aunque tal vez otras personas no me miraban aquí, Dios ya me miraba aquí.
That was His vision.
Esa era su visión.
It doesn't matter what other people say about you.
No importa qué es lo que las personas dicen de ti.
It doesn't even matter what you say about your own self.
No importa qué es lo que tú dices de ti mismo.
God already saw you there.
Dios ya te vio ahí.
God already saw you there.
Dios ya te vio ahí.
How can we transvision?
¿Cómo podemos transicionar?
Number one.
Número uno.
We need to come to God and be healed.
Necesitamos acercarnos, venir a Dios y ser sanados.
We're going to read Numbers 14:24. It says, if you guys can help me read it out loud. 1, 2, 3. But because my servant Caleb has a different spirit and follows me wholeheartedly, I will bring him into the land he went to, and his descendants will inherit it.
En cambio, mi siervo Caleb, que ha mostrado un espíritu diferente y me ha sido fiel, le daré posesión de la tierra que exploró y su descendencia la heredará.
Caleb had a different spirit.
Caleb tenía un espíritu diferente.
And he followed God wholeheartedly.
Y le siguió a Dios.
But someone that, and I was thinking, someone that has a different spirit.
Y alguien que tiene un espíritu diferente.
It's because they must be following God. They must love God, and they must know God.
Es porque deben conocer y amar y seguir a Dios, ¿no?
I mean, if he followed him wholeheartedly, he must have been close to God.
Porque si lo seguía con todo su corazón es porque estaba cerca a Dios.
We're going to read another Bible verse that says on Habakkuk 2:2. It says, and then God answered, write this when you see what you see. And I don't want to read the rest because I want to focus here the beginning that says, and then God answered.
Entonces el Señor me dijo, respondió.
So the first point is we need to come to God and be healed.
El primer punto es necesitamos venir a Dios y ser sanados.
And here in this verse it says, and then God answered.
Y aquí dice, y Dios le respondió.
How would we know what God answers if we're not close to him?
¿Cómo vamos a saber lo que Dios responde si no estamos cerca de él?
If we don't come to him,
si no venimos a él,
we must first come to him.
Necesitamos primer venir a él.
We're going to continue reading the verse. Write this, write what you see, write it out in big block letters so that it can be read on the run.
Escribe mi respuesta en letras grandes y claras para que cualquiera pueda leerla en una mirada y corra para contarlo a los demás.
How will we be able to run if maybe we're in pain with all those obstacles?
¿Cómo vamos a poder correr si estamos en dolor con todos esos obstáculos?
If we can't even see because those obstacles have blurred our vision.
Si no podemos ver porque esos obstáculos han bloqueado nuestra visión.
We need to come to God and be healed first.
Necesitamos venir a Dios y ser sanados primero.
Number two.
Número dos.
We need to write God's vision for our lives.
Necesitamos escribir la visión de Dios para nuestras vidas.
But before doing this,
pero antes de hacer eso,
I want you guys to close your eyes.
Yo quiero que cierres tus ojos.
Father, my God,
Padre,
show us those things that we need to heal.
Muéstranos las cosas que necesitamos sanar.
Show us those obstacles that are in our lives right now that have robbed our vision.
Muéstranos los obstáculos que están en nuestra vida que nos han robado la visión.
But not only show us, but also heal us from those things.
No solo muéstranos, pero sánanos de esas cosas.
Heal us, Father.
Sánanos, Padre.
Thank you, Father.
Gracias, Padre.
Number two.
Número dos.
We need to write God's vision for our lives.
Necesitamos escribir la visión de Dios para nuestras vidas.
As we read, it says, write this. Write what you see.
Dice, escribe esto, escribe lo que ves.
Write the vision of God for your life.
Escribe la visión de Dios para tu vida.
Write those promises of God for your life.
Escribe las promesas de Dios para tu vida.
On a piece of paper, write it down physically.
En un papel físicamente, apúntalo.
If you want a home, put a home there. If you want your family saved, write that promise there. My house, mi familia y yo serviremos al Señor. Put it there. My house and I shall be saved.
My family and I shall serve the Lord. Write it down. Yes. Y si quieres una casa, apúntalo también.
Write that vision that you have. If you want your family to be saved, if you want to be free from depression, write it there. I will be free from depression.
Apunta la visión, o si quieres ser libre de depresión, pon yo seré libre de la depresión.
I will be free from resentment.
Seré libre del resentimiento.
I will be financially free, financially be free from debt.
Yo seré libre de toda deuda.
I will be blessed financially.
Seré bendecido financieramente.
I will get a degree.
Me agarraré un certificado.
I will fulfill my purpose in God.
Voy a cumplir mi propósito en Dios.
Write down the vision.
Escribe la visión.
Not only that, number three.
No solamente eso, número tres.
We need to constantly read it on the run. God knew that we needed to be reminded.
Necesitamos leerlo constantemente en el correr. Dios sabía que necesitamos ser recordados.
We needed to be reminded of God's promises for our lives.
Necesitábamos recordarnos de las promesas de Dios para nuestras vidas.
Why?
¿Por
Why?
Qué?
Because he knew there would be obstacles in life.
Porque él sabía que iba a haber obstáculos en la vida.
And we needed to physically see it and constantly read it throughout life.
Y necesitábamos verlo físicamente para poder hacerlo.
That's why he asked her, write this, write what you see, write it in big block letters so that it can be read on the run.
Es por eso que él dice, escríbelo en letras grandes para que los puedas leer al correr.
So that it can be read whenever you feel weary.
Para que lo puedas leer cuando te sientes cansado.
So it can be read whenever you feel rejected.
Para que lo puedas leer cuando te sientes rechazado.
So you can be read whenever you feel tempted.
Para que lo puedas leer cuando te sientas tentado.
So it can be read whenever you feel lonely.
Para que lo puedas leer cuando te sientas solo.
So it can be read whenever you feel lost.
Para que lo puedas leer cuando te sientes perdido.
On Joshua 1:19 it says,
en Josué 1:19 dice,
have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
Ya te lo he ordenado. Sé fuerte y valiente. No tengas miedo ni te desanimes, porque el Señor tu Dios te acompañará donde quiera que vayas.
How many of you guys believe that?
¿Cuántos lo creen?